Hello, and welcome to the Amazon Simple Queue Service Connector how-to video. If you're using Amazon Simple Queue Service with AWS, you can set up an out-of-the-box connector for this fairly easily and send messages to your queue by connecting to its respective API. So here we have an example process model to demonstrate how this connector actually works. So this is a connector that will be used on a task. So if you're going to create this connector, you simply need to create a task. Go to the wrench icon, and then scroll down, and you should see the connector in the list here. Okay, so let's look at the configuration details for this connector. So the first thing that you might want to configure with this is the authentication section. So to configure this section, you'll need the access key and secret key of an IAM user that has access to this queue. Now, for these two fields, you could directly put them into the field itself, or you can actually reference this information using what's called a connector secret. We definitely recommend that you use a secret instead, just because hard coding this into your model presents certain security risks, and really this information is probably not something you want everyone to see. So this is something that can be configured in your Camunda console. So that'll be under the cluster section, and within the cluster section, there's a connector secret section as well. So if you click the dropdown, there is another authentication option. That would be the default credentials chain. So you'll select this if your system is configured as an implicit authentication mechanism. So for example, if you have credentials supplied via environment variables or files on the target host. So this option is only available for self-managed or hybrid distribution. So the next section is for the actual queue properties. And so here you're actually going to want to specify the URL of the SQS queue, right? So in general, where are we looking to connect here? Make sure you also provide the region. The region you can find easily in the URL itself if you're confused. And for the queue type, we want to put it standard unless you have a first in, first out queue configured specifically. So the next section is the input message data section. So here we can configure the actual message body. And these are going to be listed in JSON, and that will be converted to parameters that are sent in the request to Amazon. So in this case, we're just sending one parameter, the date parameter, and we're specifying that it will have a string value with the data type being string. You can also send message attributes as well. So this is like metadata that you can actually add to the message. In this case, there's just one attribute. We're just putting a simple timestamp here. Next section is the output section. So here we can specify a process variable that will contain the entire response. And if we like, we can also map certain attributes of the response to one or more process variables. The last section is the error handling section. So this will allow you to actually trigger a BPMN error depending on the response from Amazon. So an example of this might look like this. So here we're looking at the status code that we got back from Amazon. And if the status code is 400, then we can create and trigger a BPMN error with that code and also with the message that represents the error. Okay, so we'll go ahead and delete this for now since we are not handling errors in this specific example. Okay, all we need to do now is deploy and run the process. So here in Operate, we can see that we successfully executed the process. And on the bottom right, we can see the data that was stored from the response. So here we have the result var, which should contain the actual response from Amazon. And if you remember from our configuration in the process model, we actually mapped the message ID to a created message ID process variable. Okay, this is everything for now. Hope you enjoyed the video. We'll see you next time.